And we'll see that entire top five here in heat number four. The points leader after day number one was the man that needed somebody to drop out to even be here. Cody Anderson, an almost a return story from 2014, leads the way after day number one. Samuel Quant won event two. He's in second place. Mitchell Stevenson, Ryan Smith, and Brent Fikowski, the number one seed entering this, is the number five ranked athlete after day number one. The first test for these athletes here in the top 10 on day number two is our chipper event.
And that is something that Fikowski does very well with his chippers like these. You got the 100-foot lunge to start, followed by double unders. And the race in the middle of this event, 50 wall ball shots with a 30-pound ball, 10 rope climbs back to the 50, double unders and lunge to finish it out.
And we spoke about the man that is the last one in after day number one, that being Brent Fikowski. He will be in lane number three, but the first man out entering day number two, another familiar Games athlete, Cole Sager.
You know, usually on the outside looking in, you think guys get nervous. I almost want to say that Cole prefers to have kind of that outsider feel, and that just helps fuel his competitiveness. Talking going from ninth to fifth last year in the final event, I'm not worried about Cole Sager being outside in this position.
And the man that just loves to come from behind, Cody Anderson, was an alternate 45th seed in 2014 before he qualified for the Games. 41st seed this time around, and he's the points leader.
Well, I think it's just a guy who takes advantage of the opportunities that he's given. And when these events were announced, I really loved Cody Anderson's chances based off his skill set and what the events were. Now, it's almost foolish to say is that someone's going to do well just based off that, but this is a chipper. Fikowski is a just mastermind when it comes to pacing long, high-volume, high-rep events out. If anyone's going to take the heat or an event record, it's going to be Fikowski.
Every year, the past 3 years, there's that notable chipper event in the middle of the regional competition. One man has completed all three of those within the time cap, and that man is Brent Fikowski. Time to beat after three heats here in Portland. Cameron Pernich, who was way ahead of the event record pace for most of that, 12:01.74 seconds. Back in heat number two, that event record he was chasing down, held by Matt Fraser, the fittest man on earth, back in week one, number one, at 11:17.02. And all 10 athletes start on the double unders right around that 1 minute mark.
Well, and not to say someone's going to really determine how they're going to finish based off the first overhead lunges, but Fikowski was about 5 seconds ahead of Fraser's first overhead lunge if you're talking about keeping on pace with Matt Fraser.
And the professor just looking very calm with this opening set of 100 double unders. Hasn't broken yet. And he's in his final five, and he'll do all 100 double unders unbroken. Samuel Quant right in line with him. Fikowski the first one to get a wall ball completed. It's Fikowski one, Quant in the purple shirt in the middle of the screen in second. Kevin Simons on the right side of the screen in the white shirt in third.
Now, there's not a lot of athletes you'll pull aside and get an honest answer about. It's like, how excited are you to go to 50 wall ball shots with a heavy pound ball? Except, I think, for someone like Fikowski. Not only is it just because he's probably good at it, but because now he knows other people are not, and it's a great opportunity to separate himself.
And that 30-pound wall ball, he's no stranger to it. That was introduced at the Mini Ranch Chipper last year. That event won by Brent Fikowski.
What you see here is this is a great technique for high-volume sets on wall balls. What you see Fikowski doing, he just did 25 in a row, is that he's dropping his hands to the side after each rep. And what that does is that allows some of the blood flow to get back into the arms. Because think about just standing still for 2 minutes and holding your hands above your head. That's actually very hard to do. And so what he's doing is he's getting his arms a break in between every rep. That's a very smart and savvy move by Fikowski.
Putting that height to good use as well on these wall balls as the 6-2 Fikowski has opened up a healthy lead over the rest of the field. Samuel Quant is working on the second half of this 50. Cody Anderson has made the transition to that right target as well.
And you saw Fikowski did 25 unbroken, and then he's going to 15-10. Quant on the left side is keeping pace with Fikowski, so it'll be interesting to see how these guys go head-to-head when it comes to these rope climbs.
So Fikowski up on the rope, and he will be joined by Samuel Quant. As you saw his judge's hand up, that judge's hand is now down because Quant has made his way to the ropes as well.
There's an interesting technique that I haven't seen, and leave it to someone like Fikowski to figure out a new way to climb this rope. And what he's going to do is that instead of going hand over hand legless, he's going to jump up, squeeze with the inside of his legs, reach and wrap the feet. It's so methodical, and you know, seeing it for the first time, a little different. But what that's going to do is it's going to save your grip. And when you can save your grip on legless, he can take less time in between reps.
And here's the difference. Fikowski on the right, Quant on the left. Both rookies at the games 1 year ago. Quant won one event, double DT. Fikowski won a rookie record 4 events last year.
And this is just classic Brent Fikowski. Look at the pace at which he's going. Slow and methodical. Grab the bottom of the rope, jump, squeeze, reach, feet, touch. It'll be like that for every single rep.
Now, the thigh pinch strategy isn't new. We saw Katrin David's daughter do it. We saw Brooke Wells do it last week. It's the first time we've seen one of the male athletes do it, and especially with that pacing with it.
Well, he's already done 8. He has 2 more reps to go. And like I said, is that Fikowski is going to beat everybody in the middle, especially when it comes to these rope climbs. And what's most people's problem when it comes to legless? Grip fatigue, arm fatigue. There is zero grip fatigue with this style of rope climb. And just like that, Fikowski has 1 more rep.
Final rope climb for Brent Fikowski. When he makes the touch, he's going to be ahead of the event record pace of Matt Fraser. It's a question of how much, and how much is going to be 22 seconds faster than Matt Fraser's event record pace. It's still slower than the pace that was done by Cameron Pernich in heat number 2. Pernich really just kind of, hate to say this, but the second fastest time that we've seen really thus far, kind of fell off the rails on that event record pace, though, on the overhead walking lunge.
Oh, not kind of. Definitely fell off the rails. And this one thing you're not going to see Fikowski do is to blow up too early on an event that requires such pacing and meticulous strategy.
That battle for second still led by Samuel Quant on the left side of the screen. Cody Anderson is working on rep number 9. Quant will about to start on rep number 10. Rep number 10 about to be started by Mitchell Stevenson in the yellow shirt as well.
So you got your 3 guys in the middle, 5, 6, 7, working on their final rope climb.
And if you're Brent Fikowski, you're leading the way, and then you look down and you see one of your good buddies, Joe Scally, who's celebrating his 31st birthday today, has moved into the second position, and 2 of the biggest trash talkers in the sport are 1 and 2 here in event number 3. Selfishly, I kind of want to see them finish first and second just to see what happens on the overhead lunge. So Scally in the backwards cap in lane number 9 is the closest competitor to Brent Fikowski, who's almost on the opposite end of the floor in lane number 3. Also onto the wall balls already is Samuel Quant, Cody Anderson, Mitchell Stevenson, Ryan Smith as well.
Fikowski's on his last 25 on the wall ball shots. He's on the right side of the screen. And the pace hasn't quickened. It hasn't fallen off. He's breaking it up a little bit more, but look at it. It's just enough to kind of give his body a little bit of a break. And what you'll feel at the end is that you kind of feel the muscles get tired, the shoulders get tired. Let the ball drop for a couple seconds, take a deep breath, pick it back up and finish.
He has the nickname the Professor. It's not because of any career choice he's made. It's because of how much he just breaks everything down in every single event. And he is still 40 seconds ahead of Matt Fraser's event record pace as he gets back to the double unders.
I was talking to some athletes in the back about Matt Fraser's time, and I had guessed that Fikowski would be the one guy that can take it down. And they were explaining, he's like, they don't understand how fast Fraser went through this. It's like, you don't have to go fast. The good thing is that being week three, you got to see what it takes to get an event record. Fraser just did this on the whim. He was doing it week one. It's much easier to game plan through a workout when there is a time to beat. Now, at the same time, as you can do all the game planning in the world, but you still got to execute it. Fikowski is doing that beautifully.
How easy is this event for Brent Fikowski? He just had a big smile on his face as one of the MCs mentioned how far ahead he is of the rest of the field. We're at the 9-minute mark in this 16-minute time cap event, and Brent Fikowski is just casually looking around at this point as he gets ready to start this 100-foot overhead walking lunge. The regional chipper master, Brent Fikowski, way ahead of the rest of the field here in event number three.
Another thing Fikowski is good at is moving really well and being very meticulous about every single thing he does. That is what makes him successful on top of his, we'll say, workout intelligence.
A minute 30 behind him in this heat. Mitchell Stevenson has moved into the second position just ahead of Samuel Quant, but only 50 feet remains for Brent Fikowski. Unbelievable. The last 4 years, he is the only man to finish every single regional chipper event. He had the event record on the chipper, the 50s, in 2014 out in Vancouver. And he is on his way to yet another event record. The man that had more wins than anybody at the Games 1 year ago, more wins than any rookie ever at the CrossFit Games. And Brent Fikowski can add another event record with a casual wave to the crowd. The Professor wins event three with a absolutely incredible event record, 50 seconds faster than Matt Fraser.
I'm not surprised the event record's down, but I am surprised about how much he destroyed that time. Brent Fikowski is fun to watch.
And there's a good sign right there. Brent Fikowski, 50 seconds faster than Matt Fraser. And one day ago, Dave Castro said he didn't think that Fikowski had enough to win the games, that there were some holes to shore up. I wonder if Brent might have heard that and decided to put everybody on notice here that he is a threat for a title. Battle for second in the heat. Mitchell Stevenson on the left, Samuel Quant on the right. Quant entering this event in second in the point standings, 5 points ahead of the third place athlete, which is Mitchell Stevenson. Left side of the screen, Cody Anderson in gray and white in third here in the second place battle. In lane number seven is Ryan Smith. Stevenson drops the dumbbell. Quant continuing to go unbroken on this walking lunge, but that drop might have helped Stevenson as he was going faster, but it was a little too fast as he has to put the dumbbell down again. Anderson was in position to gain on them, but he drops it down. Smith has moved past Anderson, and now Smith drops the dumbbell. Battle for second in this final 10 feet. Stevenson picks up the pace, and he gets a no rep as he didn't get the extension on that lunge, and Samuel Quant will take second in the heat, and that's going to be tight with Cameron Pernich's time of 12:01.74. Give it to Quant by 15/100ths of a second.
Got another no rep because he didn't have his foot across the line on the second attempt. You got to bring the feet together past the line. So that's two no reps in the last 5 feet.
Still a top five finish for Mitchell Stevenson at 12:18 and gives sixth place. If Cody Anderson can hang on for one more step, and he will, and the points leader with, again, another strong finish.
Well, that's huge for Cody because Ryan Smith was actually 5 feet ahead of him, and one step away, he dropped the dumbbell. And it kind of seems like we've seen that from Ryan Smith all weekend, where he's pushing towards until the very end and then falls one step short.
Cole Sager was the last athlete to get to the wall balls on the first time through. He finds himself in the sixth position, trying to hold off Joe Scally one lane over. And if you're Sager, this is not what you wanted to see, nor if you're Scally. Sager came in 2 points behind Fikowski. Scally 6 points behind. Last step for Sager. And he'll be across at 13:23. Scally back onto the dumbbell. Good buddy Brent Fikowski giving him some encouragement. Nice recovery there as he missed the touch.
And that's a tough position to put yourself in with that dumbbell. His elbows flared out to the right and his shoulders turning in internally. It's very hard to stabilize like that. I said it's about the weight and it's about the positioning that these athletes can get in.
Happy birthday, Joe Scally. He's in at 13 minutes and 56 seconds on his 31st birthday, and he'll take a nap there on the finish mat. And Brent Fikowski looks like he could do that one again. He is very comfortable right now, 52 seconds faster than Matt Fraser. Three athletes left on the floor. They're all on the overhead walking lunge. The leader of these three is George Sanchez in lane number two. In lane number one, having to go back about 10 feet. It's Connor Vail entered this event in ninth. Kevin Simons on the near side is about to pass both of them. And he'll drop the dumbbell down. Sanchez back on it. Sanchez comes into this only 3 points behind Fikowski. In the seventh position.
Now you're looking deeper on the leaderboard about who this affects. And the first person I'm thinking about is actually Tyson Takasaki, who's in 19th. But he should get himself a third place finish, which is 90 points to his total. And these athletes who are failing almost to make the time cap are those athletes that he really needs to jump to get back up into that top 10.
19th place, but only 42 points outside the top five coming into this event, as Simons edges out Sanchez for position, and Connor Vail down to 15 feet remaining with 35 seconds left until the 16-minute time cap. Connor Vail, his fifth regional appearance at just 24 years old. And he will beat the time cap in at 15 minutes and 45 seconds. But there's one man that has absolutely owned Chipper events at regionals since 2013, and that man has the event record this time around, and that's Brent Fikowski.
Brent Fikowski, I tell you what, it's good he goes in week three, but if you're just an athlete trying to figure out how to do this event, you would want to watch Brent Fikowski do this in event number one and just copy everything he does, because it's so well thought out and so meticulous. The positioning overhead, how relaxed he is on his double unders. He's not thinking unbroken, he's just thinking relaxed. With 25, 15, 10 on the first part, dropping the hands to his side, give me a break. And this, just absolute beauty of ease on the rope climbs with the leg grab and then the foot grab, taking it off of his upper body. And what that does is makes the wall balls easier on the second half. Relax enough to keep an eye on the clock, and a good position change between the right to the left at the end, smashing the event record. It wasn't even close.
52-second event record for Brent Fikowski, and the professor is with Nikki Brazier.
Brent, we know you are a master of strategy, and you looked very comfortable throughout that entire event. What was your strategy going into it?
Ideally, fast and unbroken on everything. I broke up the wall balls a couple times. I just wanted to manage the rest. I knew if I put down the wall ball, I just had to pick it right back up, and I stuck to that.
You had kind of a newer move that we haven't really seen on that rope climb, where you reached up and you wrapped sort of your inner legs. How did you come up with that?
My emotional shepherd, Mitch Bernard, some of you might know him. He watched the first week of regionals. He told me Catherine David's daughter tried that out. So the next day I went to the gym and tried it a couple times and felt easier, so figured I'd give it a whirl.
It seems to work out for you. Great job here. Congrats.
So I guess